A landmark challenge is underway in the Supreme Court as Gladys Berejiklian seeks to quash a corruption finding against her. The former Premier's judicial review arguing that the ICAC not only got its report wrong, but also that it took too long.
Monday morning, business as usual, the former Premier off to work as an Optus executive as one of the nation's top silks got on with the job of trying to clear her name.
Has ICAC overstepped the mark here?
Last June, ICAC declared Gladys Berejiklian had engaged in serious corrupt conduct by keeping secret a five-year relationship with then-colleague Darryl Maguire while making funding decisions for his Wagga Wagga electorate, findings challenged in the Court of Appeal. Brett Walker SC arguing the notion that a connection is impropriety can only be regarded as a black, depressing and unrealistic view of human life. So the ministry is to be comprised of people without attachments, which is nonsense.
ICAC has already faced intense scrutiny in the court of public opinion over how long it took to release the Berejiklian report. Her legal team now argues that delay was also legally fraught.
Ms Berejiklian first called to the stand in mid-2020, the report not handed down until 2023, after Ruth McColl's term as Assistant Commissioner had officially expired. The whole report was delivered in excess of jurisdiction, Mr Walker argued.
Gladys Berejiklian and anyone else is fully entitled to have that reviewed judicially in the Supreme Court. I'm going to let them make that decision.
Representatives for ICAC this afternoon began their response, rejecting claims that there was no evidence that Ms Berejiklian was influenced by the relationship, arguing that she favoured Mr Maguire because of it. In the city, Liz Daniels, Nine News.